about today, a lot of ideas went through my mind, but the one that I finally decided on is the one that makes the most sense for this class, which is a class about communication, because it is the story of my journey to being able to learn how to communicate via written word with the rest of the English-speaking world. I'm dyslexic, so when I was in the third grade, I was at a kindergarten level, and my mom was trying really hard to try to figure out how to help me learn how to read and write. Every day I went between the lines. I don't know how many of you are familiar with that, but it's a show for kids to teach them how to read. She would make me watch it every day. I hated it. Now I love it. I can't wait to show my kids the show, but she would also have me sit on her lap every day, and we would read very, very, very basic kids' readers. But I mean, I would look at the page and see the word was, and I would say saw. And she would be extremely baffled. When I wrote, it was very cryptic, very, very misspelled, letters flipped, dyslexia. So it was about this time, in my third grade, that my mom heard of Linda Moon Bell, which is a program aimed at teaching dyslexics how to read. So quite a journey began for me. I spent multiple summers during the normal hours of the school day, rather than outside playing, inside doing what was somewhat strenuous, unusual sort of linguistic exercises, as well as learning the minutiae of the English language. And I also continued that tutoring during the school year as well, leaving my class for an hour a day to continue one-on-one tutoring for a number of years until eventually I worked my way up to my grade reading level. And beyond that, I grew to love and excel in, to love the English language and excel in the subject. To the point where last year, as a high school senior, I was taking a 300 level college writing course and receiving good marks among my peers. Despite this though, I will never stop being dyslexic. There are certain things about dyslexia that will always be there to present in my life that I'll have to deal with. I'm a slow reader. Oftentimes, you know, I'll come back to class after we had a reading assignment. My friends will be talking about how, oh, they spent half an hour on the reading. I spent 3 hours on the reading. There's a lot of work that goes into compensating for that. And there's always a level of embarrassment, quite often, which is hard to get over when you are given a reading assignment. Everyone's in class, and you all are supposed to read it silently to yourselves, and you can't keep up with everyone else. Along with that, I will never be a naturally good speller. So that, without spell check on computers, that can also be a bit of a struggle. But despite all these things, or rather because of them, I think, I have really grown to love literature and writing. I have a very strong love-hate relationship with English, and I am very grateful for that. Yeah, and that will never end.